I just slapped a Xeon chip in this Optiplex and I've been using it for over 2 months. Is it worth it? The fastest CPUs you can get for socket 1155 is the Core i7-3770K, non-K, and S. This does mean that these CPUs are highly desirable and sell for anywhere between 70 to 100 bucks. That is dangerously close to the much faster 4-core 8-thread Ryzen chip, the Ryzen 3 3100. But the Core i7 is not the only way to get 4 extra threads and maybe a clock speed bump. Xeon's E3-1200s are compatible with most socket 1155 boards, including the Dell Optiplexes, even if they're not using the C-series chipset. I didn't even have to do anything else to the system other than enabling hyper-threading in the BIOS. I tested two Xeon chips. First is the Xeon E3-1245, a 4-core, 8-thread, 32-nanometer Sandy Bridge chip with integrated HD P3000 graphics. Next is the E3-1240V2, a 22-nanometer Ivy Bridge chip. The E3-1240V2 is also the most similar to the Core i7-3770, being only 100 MHz slower and lacking an iGPU. For baseline, we have the Core i5-3470 that comes with a lot of pre-builds from this time period. This i5 is a plain, quad-core, 22-nanometer Ivy Bridge chip with integrated HD 2500 graphics. Another key difference is that Sandy Bridge is limited to PCIe 2.0, while Ivy Bridge chips use PCIe 3.0. For the test platform, we have the Optiplex 7010MT itself, with its proprietary Dell Q77-based motherboard on the A21 BIOS with Spectre and Meltdown patches disabled. For graphics, we have the X-Mining Sapphire Nitro RX 570 4GB running at 1300 MHz on the Adrenaline 20.2.2 driver. Finally, RAM is 12 gigs of DDR3 at 1333 MHz CL9 from SK Hynix running at dual channel. The CPU is cooled using the 95-watt Dell stock cooler, which is still chunkier than the Intel stock cooler. Single-threaded didn't improve much, as the clock speed differences are at most 200 MHz, and Ivy Bridge is a mere die shrink of Sandy Bridge. It's in multi-threaded, where the i7 equivalent Xeon shine, with the older Sandy Bridge E3-1245 beating the Ivy Bridge i5-3470 by 27%. The Ivy Bridge E3-1240V2 did even better at 40%. That extra 200 MHz on the E3-1240V2 when scaled across all 4 cores and 8 threads definitely helped. Other heavily multi-threaded tasks also reflect a similar improvement, like the 7-zip file compression and decompression, as well as 3D rendering and Blender cycles. Though in cycles, my RX 570 just crushed the CPUs. Video encoding and decoding is a mix of somewhere between core speed and the number of threads. DaVinci Resolve uses the GPU for decode, but you have the option what to use for encode. Using the native CPU encoder, the Xeons do improve export times, albeit not as dramatically as Cinebench scores. For kicks, I still included my RX 570 again, doing the encode, and it crushed the CPUs. But do keep in mind that in lower bit rates, the CPU will produce a better quality output than the GPU. Quick-sync video processing between Sandy Bridge and Ivy Bridge is far apart. Quick-sync in the i5-3470 in the Handbrake quick-sync-only test is 55% faster. Software support is also something to keep in mind. Premiere Pro 2019 did not work with the E3-1245's older Sandy Bridge quick-sync, but it works flawlessly in the i5-3470's newer Ivy Bridge QuickSync. I don't play a lot of games. For game testing, all I have is GTA 5, Minecraft, and Firestrike. Not exactly comprehensive, and none of the newer, heavily multi-threaded titles. GTA 5 did have a bit of an overall FPS improvement using the E3 1240 V2, most likely from being 200 MHz faster. Even the 1% and 0.1% minimums didn't show any improvements compared to the plain quad-core i5. Minecraft Java Edition, being a single-threaded piece of shit, benefited from the 200 MHz faster E3 1240 V2. But what's odd is that the older E3 1245 got much weaker minimums in the plains and forests, while at the shopping district, it got lower averages. Not sure why. In Firestrike, the Xeons got higher GPU scores and substantially higher physics scores, but the combined scores aren't much to talk about. Testing thermals is near impossible to get reliable data. The CPU fan can either run fully automatic, which is inconsistent, or at full blast, where any differences will become negligible. With the fans fully automatic, RPMs as close as possible, and ambient temperatures as close as possible, I can still say that the older E3 1245 seems to run hotter. To maintain the same load temperature as the newer E3 1240 V2, the CPU cooler has to run 400 RPM faster to maintain the same temperature. I'll ignore the idle temps, as that's the most unreliable.
We'll be right back after the break.
God damn, that was a lot of tests, and that is still nowhere near what bigger YouTube channels do on a regular basis. Makes you think about the amount of work required to do this. Now, it wasn't easy to hunt down these Xeons like this at a fair price. A fair price is something like 50 bucks, since a brand new Ryzen 3 3100 is $100 and is almost twice as fast. Also remember that these Xeons will only get you 4 extra threads and only a little bit of extra clock speed, so you shouldn't overpay for these old chips. If you can't find these chips at a fair price, don't bother. But let's say these eBay sellers and buyers finally have enough sense in them, and the prices drop to what these chips are really worth compared to newer chips, or if you find these chips show up at a fair price, like I did, is it worth it? During times when I tax the CPU hard, these extra threads definitely prevent the CPU from choking. Video editing responsiveness has also improved noticeably. Now, I can't say the same when gaming. The games I tested are older games that favor per-core performance over extra threads, unlike some newer games which are heavily multi-threaded. So it's still best to check if the games you want to play would benefit from the extra threads. If you are still rocking a dual-core i3, get an i5 or equivalent Xeon. It's no-brainer at this point, as these chips are like 20 bucks or so. Going from i5 to i7 only adds extra threads, and only worth it at the right price, and if the clock speed is equal or faster than the i5 it's replacing. Likers gonna like, haters gonna hate. Subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss any of my future videos. The next video is me packing all of this up and moving across the country towards west. Thank you for watching.